Friends, today we will see about night square. It has been the fascination and imagination of the mathematicians all over the world to construct a 8x8 magic square on the lines of the night square in the chessboard. So, what is the connection between the magic square, 8x8 magic square, and the chessboard? 8x8 magic square also contains 8 rows, 8 columns. Okay, totally 64 cells it has got. And likewise, chessboard also has got 8 rows and 8 columns. So, there has been a fascination. Somehow, the mathematicians were thinking that, can we plot a magic square in a chessboard using the night square method? Okay, so this has been the work of many of the mathematicians, including Leonhard Euler. He was a very prolific mathematician, and at his 40th age he went blind, completely blind, and he lived after that for about more than 3 decades he lived, but still he was an exceptional mathematician, and he did all the mathematics in his mind. In fact, the most of the mathematical discoveries that he made were done after he became blind. Okay, we are going to see about today we are going to see 5 night squares. Okay, of that 5, one is constructed by my mother, Mrs. Indira Narasinghe Rao. So I am very happy to present this, because at some point, at some level, her work was akin to Euler's work, or Janisch, Fiestemal, and Wenzelheide. These great people's square and my mother's magic square also has some resemblance. I'm very happy to say this. First, we are going to see the Janisch night square. Okay, we all know that in chessboard there are various powers there. Okay, various powers. One is called as queen, one is called as king, bishop is there, rook is there, knight is there. Knight is nothing but horse. So it has got a peculiar move. So the mathematicians were thinking whether they can construct a knight square in a 8x8 format, so that it traverses in such a way. When it starts here, one, in you put two at its landing place after one, and at the landing place after that, at its third move we name it as 3, and fourth move after its starting we name it as 4. Fifth move after that we call it as that place we call it as 5, like that. So like that, this knight traverses and ends here. A knight's move can be two types. One is open ended, one is open, another one is closed. Closed means from 64 you have to use the same knight's method to come back to the place of origin or 1. So that this loop will be going on endlessly. So this is closed loop. Or this is also called a re-entrant knight square. Okay. This Janisch knight square is an example of closed knight store, and also it's an example of re-entrant knight square. Okay, but does it give you the magic square? So rule of the magic square is this: we have to use in a 8x8, we have to use numbers from 1 to 64. Each number should be used only once, and all the rows should give you 260, all the columns should give you 260, and both the diagonals this way and this way should give you 260. So while this Janisch knight square fulfills these row sum, all these row sum 260, all these are column sum 260, but it doesn't fulfill the diagonals. Okay, so one of the diagonals is 256, another diagonal is 264. So that way we cannot term this Janisch knight square as a magic square. At the best we can term it as a semi magic square. There is also one more peculiarity that we will explore in these magic squares. A 4x4 magic square could be considered to be consisting of 4 4x4 magic squares. 1, 2, 3, 4. If 8 numbers gives you 260, we can assume that at least four numbers should give you 130. So there are some certain squares like that, but this square, on our observation, it doesn't happen that way for this square. So these four numbers gives you 164, and these four numbers gives you 96. But you add these eight numbers, it gives you 260. So if the half magic sum also gives you, if full magic sum is 260, so naturally you'll expect a half magic sum to be 130. But here the row sum is for one of the four, one of it is 164, another one is 96. Likewise column, this one column is 164 and this another column is 96. So but overall this gives you 260. So this is just an observation. Okay, so now we have finished Janish night square. Okay, now we will go into Euler's night square. As I said to you, Euler was a very prolific mathematician, and you know, we can talk on and on about him, but we are going to dedicate a separate video for him. So one of my favorite mathematicians. Okay, he said that he was having a very big family. So he said, sometimes I get the great mathematical thoughts when I am holding my toddler son, like that he says like that. So these people, you know, genius, they relate something to somewhere, some naturally occurring event to some concept, some ideas in mathematics. So they live in a different plane of life altogether. We are going to see a lot about him at a separate video. Okay, and this Euler square, one starts here, two here, three here, four, five, six, like that it goes. Where does it end? It ends at 64. One starts here, 64 starts here. From 64, the knight cannot travel to 1 using the knight's method. So from 64, if it has to come to 1, it has to make a very big jump from 64 to 1. So therefore, this Euler square is an example for the open knight stone. Okay. So here, how does it happen? Here, how does it happen? You see, all the 8 rows gives you 260, all the 8 columns gives you 260, diagonals doesn't give you 260, one diagonal gives you 210, another diagonal gives you 282. But you see the beauty here, it has got 4 subsquares. Okay, these 4 add up to 130, and these 4 add up to 130, these 4 add up to 130, and these 4 add up to 130, diagonals don't add up to 130. Okay, that is the only drawback here, but this is a very beautiful, very, you know, wonderfully chiseled magic square, constructed magic square, and we have to fall in love with all these mathematicians, especially with Euler, such a great mathematician. Okay, we will see one more square. This is Euler square, cannot also be called as a magic square, this can be called only as a semi-magic square. Third one, we are going to see Fils-Thomas square. This Fils-Thomas night square is actually a magic square. It also follows the knight's move pattern here. One starts here, 2, 3, 4, then 5, 6, like that it goes. It starts at 1, ends at 32 here. From there, it doesn't follow the knight's move, it follows a rook move here to come to 33. From 33, 34, 35, 36, like that it goes, and ends at 64. So it's note that 64 and 1 are in the same line, a same row, and 32 and 33 are also in the same row. Okay, so there are two distinct stores here. One starts here and ends here, another starts here and ends here. From 64 it cannot come to 1 using the knight's move method. So this is also an example for the open knight's tour method. Okay, but it has got a wonderful property. You see, add 5 plus 60, you get 65. Add 14 plus 51, you get 65. 53 plus 12, 65. 62 plus 3, 65. Likewise, 34 plus 31, 65. 43 plus 22 is 65. 26 plus 39, 65. 57 plus 8, 35. Like that, you see a very tremendous, very nice pattern here in the Sri Sthoma square. Using the Knight's Tool method, this was the first magic square, first square that fulfilled, gave the magical properties also. So all the four rows, it gives you 260. All the four columns, it gives you 260. Diagonals also gives you 260. And we will see, examine the each individual 4x4. So these four gives you 134. These four gives you 126. So these four give you 132. And these four gives you 128. So these inner 4x4 subsquares are not magic squares. Okay. But still, overall it retains the magical properties for 8x8. Though this 4 is 134 and this 4 is 126. Both of them put together gives you 260. Likewise, these 4 gives you 152 and these 4 gives you 108. But overall it gives you 260. So overall this is a magic square. So we will see one more square. Next one is the Venzelite Knight square. Okay. It is an example for the closed knight square or re-entrant square. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that it goes. 5, then 6, like that it goes, and it's at 64. From 64, it can use the knight's move method to come into 1. Therefore, this is a closed knight's tour. It is also an example for the re-entrant square. Okay, how does it fare? So, all the rows gives you 260. All the columns gives you 260. Diagonals gives you different numbers, 192 and 328. But what happens, so therefore this can be termed only as a semi-magic square. These four add up to 148 and these four add up to 112. These four add up to 112 and these four add up to 148. So these individual 4x4 subsquares are not magic squares. But overall it gives you 260 for row, 260 for the column. Okay, this is an example for the re-entrant square as we saw earlier. Okay, now we will see the square constructed by my mother, Mrs. Indira Narsingha. Call it Indira's method. My mother didn't know anything about re-entrant night store, open night store, closed night store. She never knew anything about that. She just sat down, she was just working on this problem for years together, and she found out the method. So she starts how 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the Knight's Tour method. So it goes like this horizontally. Another Knight's Tour method is also there. After it reaches 4, it comes back to 1, and from here it starts 5. 5, this is a vertical move. After that, horizontal move, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then again it comes to 5, makes a nice Knight's Tour method here, 9, 10, 11, 12. Like that it goes. So this is an example for Knight's Tour method, but my mother never knew anything about Knight's Tour at all. Okay, she just constructed it this way. So this square has got a very interesting properties. See, all the 8 rows gives you 260, all the 8 columns gives you 260, and the diagonals also gives you 260 260, and so therefore for 8x8 this is the perfect magic square. Okay, each 4x4 is there. This is one 4x4 subsquare, another 4x4 subsquare, this is one more 4x4 subsquare, this is one more 4x4 subsquare. So how does it fare? You see, these four add up to 130. And these four add up to 130. And these four add up to 130. These four add up to 130. But the diagonals don't give you 130 for a 4x4 subsquare. But it gives you 260 for the 8 numbers. So that's the beauty of this. So this is one way of looking at it. See, these four numbers gives you 130. 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 These four numbers don't give you 130. These four numbers gives you 130. This gives you 130. This gives you 130. This gives you 130. Likewise for the whole 8x8. So to see more of these kind of magic squares, kindly subscribe to my channel and also give your valued like, share, comments, etc. So that gives you, that gives me motivation to go to the next level. Okay, thank you. Good day, gentlemen. Thank you. Bye.